how we're doing. Ronnie Woods. Back out again. Oh yes, you know it. This time we are at Amberley. Camping in the Arundel Forest this time. Should be a good laugh actually. Again, it's part of the group. Mental, outdoors and mental wellbeing UK group that I run. Yeah, this time we're going out doing a bit of bushcrafting, a bit of foraging. It's a pretty much a learning camp this one is. It's gonna be fun. So yeah, just waiting to get picked up now. Properly excited, chugga chug, bring it on. I'm gonna enjoy this one. Chat to you soon. Wah! Right, so here we are, guys. We are now in Amberley. There's Peter and Sue. They've very kindly picked me up from the station. We just had a whole drama about parking with some woman saying it's a private road, and it's clearly not a private road. But yeah, such is life. But yes. Ooh, pretty, pretty, pretty. I like this. I think it's been a month since I was last out, so... yeah, it's very good to be back out again. And it's good to be out with people I know. Oh dear, whatever happened to my solo camping? Morning, guys. How are we doing? Right, well, I didn't do much filming yesterday. Just didn't get around to it. Done a quick setup. And then, yeah, a few beers, a bit of food. And we're all sitting around the fire having a chat. So far, so good. Very much enjoying it. And we'll do a review on the tarp and setup in a bit. I may do that as a standalone video. Not too sure yet. But yeah, it got a bit cold last night. Definitely got a bit cold. Kind of feel like I should have brought the under blanket with me. But yeah. It's about 7:30 now. I haven't seen movement from anybody else. That doesn't mean nobody's awake. Just haven't seen any movement yet. But yes, today we're gonna get out, do a bit of foraging, learn a few things. Should be interesting. Get some dandelion chips last night, or dandelion root chips. Quite nice. Had some root stuff, noodly type stuff. I don't know what it's called, can't remember. Really nice, very much enjoyed that. It tasted like noodles. It really tasted like noodles, like, you know, the thin crispy noodles. Like, lovely, really like those. Like, yeah. Can see me like living off the land from now on. Right, I'm gonna get ready. Well, not get ready, but kind of get up. I need coffee. It's cold.
Really hard to blow it. It's still a bit damp.
It's now when it's
yeah, it's done now.
Now it's all right. So it will just take these finest.
Yeah, it creates basically. It's the same way if you put too much voltage down electrical cable. So that's an ember, so basically we get a...
But you've got a little bit of wire wall left, and you have to get fire. You'll get enough residue voltage out of a lithium battery.
Yeah.
If you yeah. Break it open, for that to go.
Brilliant, so fire by electricity.
We've got fire on solar. So this is a parabolic mirror. So you put your finger in there, place it at the sun, and it will flex it, and it focuses on that point.
Oh, incredible.
So, Pete, if you didn't have a parabolic mirror,
yeah,
I could make you one.
Yeah.
From da-da.
Ah.
Yeah. So this is flint and steel. You basically need a high carbon steel, which are what our knives are made of.
Okay.
So you can use a piece of flint, there's flint everywhere, and the back of your knife.
Mm-hmm.
personally, if you just paid £300 for a knife, I wouldn't be sticking it on a piece of steel. Yeah. These, I'm going to have a go at making some char cloth later. So basically, you'd find an edge, put your char cloth there, and that gives you your sparks.
Okay.
So it's basically it's scraping pieces of metal off. Yeah, try and catch it on an edge so it shaves. Turn the anchor, that's it. Just need to be a high carbon steel.
So I've seen, I've done it before with two stones.
Yeah.
There has to be a specific kind of like...
False gold normally. Yeah. False gold is clean.
Okay.
That's the best way. But false gold is... It's fairly easy to find in this area.
So why would you use this one to just have the fire in some like concentrated ones?
It all comes back to getting an ember.
Yeah.
With an ember, you can create fire.
Yeah.
You start from really small.
Yeah. Basically, you get your tinder and make it into like a bird's nest. Okay. So your ember would then go inside there, close it up, and blow it to flame. So we've got things called fire pistons. These are obviously man-made in this country. It works under compression.
I've not seen one of these before.
Not in a fire piston?
No, never seen it. It's brand new to me. See, learning.
So which category is this?
This is compression.
Compression.
So you know...
But that's not one of the six, is it?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. This is used by sort of native South Americans.
Okay.
This is sort of their way.
I have no idea.
Right. So, we need to use char cloth for this. We'll have a crack at making char cloth later. I'll show you guys how it's made. I've never been very good at it. My sense to turn up in dust. I'm a char dust. So there's a little recess in the end. Char cloth goes in there. That then goes into the piston. And then we sit there and thump.
Yeah. How incredible. What does that?
That is fantastic.
Compression. Pure compression. So you've got an ember. I've got to admit, that's the first time I'm really impressed. It's hard on the hands.
Yeah.
And
the knee.
Has to hit it hard. Okay, compression.
Okay.
So down and up, yeah?
Yeah. As hard as you can. Smash it down and grab it. That was on film.
Nah.
Again, this is all stuff that you guys can buy.
Yeah.
You know, just get it online and have a practice. You know, it's
crazy.
But you'll find a lot of them for sale, used once.
Yeah. Yeah.
Very good find.
Collection only.
Steve said if
you don't get it in the first five,
it kills your hands.
I failed.
Go back.
Oh man, I failed. It's rubbish.
Susanna, you're lighting this one.
Gunpowder.
Well, that would be dangerous.
One part,
a little bit of that.
That's taking a minute.
Sorry, can everyone see?
Someone has to close in.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what was that liquid we just put in there?
This is going to...
Just glycerin.
Oh, okay.
Glycerin. That's why... Ooh. I was thinking it will mix.
How cool is that?
Oh, I love it. I love this most.
Typical of a witch.
So, chemical. Definitely the best.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So, this is potassium permanganate.
Right.
And this is glycerin. Glycerin.
Keep them separate.
Absolutely.
Yeah, especially not in the same pocket.
So glycerin is basically a soap, and potassium permanganate you would keep in your bushcraft kit because you could use it to make water soap.
Yeah, it's sterilisation, isn't it? Yeah.
I bought it off online.
Okay.
It's medical grade potassium permanganate.
Okay.
We have a problem. When making fire, we need to be aware of secondary fires.
Okay.
There was a guy, but also look at what you're building your fire on. There's a guy out in America, he cleared all the ground, built a fire, but he built his fire on top of a coal seam. So the fire that he built is still raging now for 60 years. It went down under the ground, keeps burning, and then pops up. Has another fire, starts a forest fire, goes back underground again, and they can't put it out.
Is he still ongoing?
As far as I know, it's still going.
That's amazing.
I'll research that. I am curious.
So, you know, in the news a couple of months ago with Saddleworth Moor?
Yeah.
That fire. Now, that's still burning underground in sections.
Yeah, because it's peaty ground, isn't it? Yeah.
Right.
So a V fire faces away from the wind. So you stack your sticks up like that.
Oh yeah, I love this one.
There will be a wind coming, isn't it?
So yeah, this one is really good if it's wet. So the wind is facing this way. So basically, when you build your fire in here, and the wind blows the fire onto your wood.
Okay.
If it's raining, it will keep going.
It's this is the one we've done last time, and I love it.
It's almost like turning it
into going.
Yeah, the last one we'd use, in cold weather, sort of in the Arctic or something like that. So you have two sticks, or two, basically you're using logs, that sort of diameter. And you'd stack your logs, you'd have a fire here, your logs be stacked up.
I like this.
This is cool.
Like this. And then as the fire burns down here, the logs roll in. So it's a self-feeding fire. It's called a long log because you'd be making it with logs 6 feet long. So your bed would be here, your fire's here, but also where you've got a screen with the logs, the heat bounces back off and goes to where you're lying.
We need to try this one.
So you'd use that sort of, you know, in the Arctic or where it's cold.
You can
do that. You build this if you're in sort of arboreal woods, you would have you'd have a very steep lean-to, because if it's a shallow, you get the snow will land on it. It gets heavier and heavier, then the whole thing collapses and lands on you. So you'd have it very, very steep. It'd be steeper than this. And then obviously you'd have your fire in front of you. So basically you're caught between the fire, the heat will reflect both ways, so it will reflect off your shelter and reflect off the logs.
Be nice and warm then.
Yeah, you can sleep out in the Arctic without a sleeping bag.